Thank you. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here. I can only, I guess, relate to my experiences as a whistleblower from NSA. When you first start experiencing some of the illegality and major corruption that was involved in government, it's really hard for anybody with character and integrity to stay there and work for the government. It's really difficult. But then when you try to work inside the channels that you're given by the government to deal with the corruption, fraud, waste, abuse, criminality, and that includes the inspector generals of the Department of Justice and of Defense, and the intelligence committees, all those avenues that they give you that they say are the right way to go and the proper way to go, like they say about Edward Snowden, should have taken that. That's what we did. That's what Kirk and I did and others. And we were met not just with stonewalling, but also with counterattacks. They basically attacked us with the FBI to silence us. So they sent them to raid us and all of that. So it's really what's happening. Our government is turning into more of a totalitarian state. And I said this in Jane Merritt's article, that or within Jim Bamford's article he wrote in Wired a year later, where I thought we were about that far from a totalitarian state. And I think we're still getting a lot closer, especially with the NDAA and things that they're passing, like Section 1021 in the NDAA, where that gives the president the ability to declare somebody a terrorist threat and have the military take them off the street and incarcerate them. Well, I draw the analogy directly to Special Order 48 issued by the Nazis in 1933 that said exactly the same thing. You can go on the web, query it, and you can see it says exactly the same thing. And that's how they got rid of all of their enemies. And you can see what the IRS is doing with the Tea Party and various other organizations in terms of political stalling their political activism or subverting it. So this government is really creating that kind of atmosphere on top of that, where internally they're threatening everybody that works for them. In one form or another, they try to abuse that with us. And internally in NSA, they broadcast some of the things that they said about us and some of the, like the 60 Minutes program that was done in May of 2011 on us. That was also broadcast internally in the NSA network to say, see, this is what happens to people who complain about us. And so now, then they talked with Tom Drake. They fabricated evidence, was framing him. This was an outright frame. This was criminal. By the Department of Justice, they framed him and took him to trial. So and they used that in turn to intimidate everybody that works for the government. So that kind of atmosphere is coming back and silencing everyone. And so the reporters now are having difficulty getting sources to talk to them. All of these things are happening because our government is becoming this totalitarian state. And this is what we experienced early on, and it's only gotten worse. I mean, the surveillance activity that's on now is so oppressive. I mean, it's almost in everything that you do. If you do anything electronically, they're in it, and they're watching you. Now, fortunately, they can't figure that out yet on a large scale. But they can, because they're still manually left, they have to manually look at this data. Well, I know these people personally, so they're not going to get there. So for a number of decades anyway. But the point is they're setting the stage for this to continue and to the point where everybody could be monitored almost constantly throughout the day. That is an oppressive, suppressive state. That's like the Stasi on super steroids. So these are the kinds of things we experienced in our attempts to blow the whistle. And as far as I'm concerned, when Clapper issued that statement about what no employees or former employees of the intelligence community can talk about the Snowden material, I refuse to give up my First Amendment's rights to speak about anything in the public domain, and specifically about things like the Fairview program, which shows 80 to 100 sites inside the continental United States where they're collecting all your data, phone calls, recording that, collecting all the digital data on the network, all the emails, all of that data, and storing it in places like Bluffdale. These are the things that they're doing. And that program that Edward Snowden, thank you very much, Edward, exposed with the one slide on the Fairview program. If you go look at it on the web, you'll see what I mean. it will show you, and there's an awful lot of money behind this, and this is really what the key is. There's tens of billions of dollars every year behind all these programs that the government has created, because they've created this empire of secrecy and this empire of collection of information. That creates for example, that's why they had to build the $2.5 billion facility in Utah, the Bluffdale facility, because it was storing. They need a place to store this data. This is all for the FBI and the DEA to use to go against individuals. But the point is that each of those sites, if you look at the Fairview program, was tens of million dollars to build. So you multiply to 80 by 100 by tens of millions. Some of them, depending on the size, the dimensions, could be 100 million. So that's an awful lot of money over time. And for example, on the order of 70 billion a year goes to contractors to support this entire organization of the intelligence community. So our government is really going down a very ugly path. And so I'm not going to sit by and stay quiet and let that happen. I'm going to stand up and do the job that my elected officials and everybody in Congress and the courts should be doing, which is defending the Constitution. And it's great to have an organization come up that's going to help us do that. And that's why I'm here. Thanks.